There are so many movies that dramatize the psychiatric disorders that you've spent years researching. So I'm curious if there's common misconceptions about the mind that you'd like to set straight.
Oh yeah, I mean, one of the biggest ones is really that we don't use all of our brain. Like, you know, what if we only use 10% of our brain, and what if we could use all of it? Like we can access it through this or that. So there are these films like Limitless or Lucy, you know, and that's a real big misconception. Like maybe we're only consciously aware of like 10% of what's happening in our brain, but we use all of our brain all the time. None of it is redundant. It uses so many resources. It takes so much blood flow, energy, you know, it's efficient. We're not going to be like just having some bits that are there just in case, you know? So that's a common misconception. The other is that there's sort of left brain, right brain people, you know, like artsy people or right brained and more logical, rational people or left brain. That's really not how it works. Creativity is involving all different parts of the brain. It's not left versus right. And then one other misconception is that, you know, people tend to label people as like with psychiatric illness as like they're crazy and it's like this permanent thing. And, you know, and it's not necessarily how it works. Unless you're talking about very severe mental illness, but there's a lot of ebbs and flows. You know, somebody who has OCD, they might have a really like a period where it's very intense and then it gets better for a number of years. And then there's another intense period or depression. So a lot of times the symptoms severity can vary across a lifetime. And it's not like you get this one label and that's it. Like you're, you know, quote unquote crazy and, you know, forevermore. And so there's a lot of variability with mental illness that I think a lot of films, you know, they have a caricature of mental illness, which is not necessarily the case. Mm-hmm.